Hello and welcome to News 9. I'm Nishchita, and first up, the 6th ACMM court has granted bail to Devishree Guruji, who was arrested in Krishnagiri after videos of his alleged affairs with devotees were leaked to the media. A defiant Devishree, who spoke to media persons while being whisked away into the police vehicle, maintained that he was innocent and that it is all a political conspiracy against him.
ಮುಂದೆ ನಾನು ಕೋರ್ಟ್ಗೆ ಹಾಜರು ಪಡಿಸ್ತಿದ್ದೇನೆ. ಅಲ್ಲಿಂದ ಬಂದ ನಂತರ ಎಲ್ಲಾ ಮಾಧ್ಯಮಗಳ ಜೊತೆ ಬಂದು ನಾನು ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಏನ್ ನಡೆದಿದೆ ಸತ್ಯ ಸಂಗತಿಗಳನ್ನ ತಿಳಿಸ್ತೀನಿ. ಇದೆಲ್ಲವೂ ಸುಳ್ಳು ಆರೋಪ, ಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ವೈಯಕ್ತಿಕ ಕಾರಣಗಳಿಂದ ಕೆಲವರು ಮಾಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ದಯವಿಟ್ಟು ನಾನು ಅದು ಬಂದು ಚಾನಲ್ ಮಾಧ್ಯಮಗಳೆಲ್ಲ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ತಿಳಿಸ್ಕೊಡ್ತೀನಿ.
Well, a special team of HSR layout police had tracked him down near Krishnagiri in Tamil Nadu yesterday. The police have also questioned him about an alleged life threat he gave to his car driver, who is the whistleblower in this case. His medical examination was conducted at the Jayanagar Government Hospital, and he was also questioned about the alleged involvement he had in a few cheating and theft cases. Devishree came to the limelight after a video of him having a relationship with one of his devotees was leaked by his own driver. Devishree had come to Bengaluru 10 years ago and has a foundation of his own. He claims to carry out many charitable works and is also believed to have profound knowledge in astrology. And today Devishree, even as he was being released on bail after being taken into custody yesterday, asserted that he is innocent and that his innocence will be proven in the days to come, and it's all a political conspiracy. Moving on now, Chris Gayle was in Bengaluru today and my colleague Harshan Shah caught up with him. Let's take a look as to what he had to say.
Hello and welcome to the special report. We are here with the man who many believe can turn around fortunes for RCB. To start with, Chris, how are you doing now? How's your health?
I'm not too bad, to be honest with you. Looking to be, fully, back on the track. I played the last game. That's a plus for us. And, things haven't started really well. So hopefully, we can get back to the winning groove and entertain our fans. So, we're back home now. We're accustomed to these conditions. So hopefully, things can actually progress for you.
So on a personal level, are you feeling 100% fit? Because you've been out of the game for a bit now. So are you feeling 100% fit?
It's never 100% fit, but like I said, sometimes, you have to make sacrifice and, try and get on with it and, try and cope with it. But, a couple of days off, hopefully you can get to that 100% leading up to the next game. So we'll see how the next couple of days goes and, with a bit of treatment and everything. So we take it into stride.
Right. Chris, now you're the big hitter, right? The fans rave about your strength, how you can hit the ball so hard. Just a bit about your fitness regime, your gym sessions, if you can tell the fans about it.
Well, the physio do a lot of work, try and massage your ear as much as possible so you can loosen the muscle a bit more, and we do some core exercises and strengthen the body as we go on. But these things are just customary for an athlete to actually on the recovery basis. So it's pretty much normal what everybody will do, once they are injured. So nothing out of the ordinary. Just do what I'm accustomed doing, apart from that, go to the gym, do a bit of strength work and, hit the nets.
Chris, about the IPL now, you've almost achieved everything, right? You've created records, you've broken records. How do you motivate yourself, to go ahead and still perform better?
How do I motivate myself? Yeah. What if you watch a few other actresses on TV, say, look at the ladies and like, wow, yes, I got to go and entertain the fans and the actress will be happy and so they'll come and see me and then I'll say like, hi Chris, how are you? And then I give them a big hug. So those little simple things can motivate you as a cricketer, but I don't know if it will work for other people, but it can work for me as well. And like I said, to be privileged to actually do these sort of things, it's wonderful. I mean, a lot of people would love to be in this position as we go on. So you look at the brighter side, a lot of people would love to be here. So while I'm here, I'll accept it and, do what I do best and entertain as much as possible without, complaining.
Right. So when you speak about actresses, is there anybody you want to send out a message to?
I sure don't know the self. No messages really, but, that's to the younger fans.
Any special actor, any actress you want to meet?
I know what you're talking about. The actress who want to meet. I think all the Bollywood actresses want to meet Chris Gayle. I think they want to meet me. Right? Am I right? See, they know what I'm saying.
Right. Okay. So, Chris, we're going to wrap it up now with a selfie on the phone. Yeah. So, this is the new trend.
Yes.
This is how it goes. Right, and we're going to get a bit of help from him, yeah?
Yeah, it's not a...
Right, so to wrap it up, Chris, now, just a message out to the fans, RCB fans, you're back on home ground after the UAE leg. It has been a bit of mixed fortunes, so how do you plan to go ahead now with the Chinnaswamy Stadium and the RCB leg?
Well, you know, RCB fans, you know, we're back. You know, it's always a rocking, you know, stadium when we actually play here. So we're looking forward to the continuous support, you know, like which you have given us the last couple of years. It's been phenomenal, and you know, hopefully we can, you know, get back on the winning ways. Come out and support us. You know, we're going to give you what you guys are asking for: win more games, have more fun, do more dances. You know, create history, records, you name it. You know, so we just got to, you know, get that winning start back in the groove again.
Thanks a lot, Chris. So that was Chris Gayle speaking to us exclusively with camera person Raghu. This is Harshan Shah for News 9.
And well, moving on to some other news. Now, mangoes have delayed to enter the markets this year. Besides, they may not taste so sweet going by the price factor this time around. Yes, the king of fruits is being sold at a much higher price compared to last year. Here's a report.
Look at the range of mangoes that have hit the market in the last 10 to 12 years. There are big-sized Malgoas, glowing Raspuris, the favorite of the masses Alfonsos, and many more. Of course, you can buy them, but you have to spend more this time around. They are going to create a hole in your pocket for sure.
Now, daragalannu saha gamanisidaga, kalada varshakku ee varshakku holike madidaga, botheka jaasine ant helabodu. Kelavondu totapuri, nantara Alfonso, ivugalalli yavade reetiya ondu ದರ ಏರಿಕೆ ಕಂಡುಬಂದಿರುವುದಿಲ್ಲ ಬೇಡಿಕೆ ಈಗ ಈಗ ಒಂದು 15 ದಿವಸದಿಂದ ಈಗ ಪ್ರಾರಂಭ ಆಗಿದೆ ಇನ್ನೂ ನಮಗೆ ಸಾಕಷ್ಟು ಪ್ರಮಾಣದಲ್ಲಿ ಬರ್ತಾ ಇಲ್ಲ ಈಗ ಪ್ರಥಮವಾಗಿ ಅಥವಾ ಪ್ರಾರಂಭವಾಗಿ ಈಗ ಕನಕಪುರ ರಾಮನಗರ ಚನ್ನಪಟ್ಟಣ ಈ ಒಂದು ಪ್ರದೇಶಗಳಿಂದ ಬರ್ತಾ ಇದೆ
ದಿ ಏರಿಯಾಸ್ ನೋನ್ ಫಾರ್ ಗ್ರೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಮ್ಯಾಂಗೋಸ್ ಡಿಡ್ ನಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಮಚ್ ರೇನ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಅಫೆಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ದಿ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಕೋಲಾರ್ ಶ್ರೀನಿವಾಸಪುರ ರಾಮನಗರ ಚಿಕ್ಕಬಳ್ಳಾಪುರ Doddapulapura are the prominent areas from where Bengaluru gets his mangoes. But the rain gods have played spoil sport. It is obvious that the mango farmers have hiked the prices since crop output is less. We will give you the prices of different varieties of mangoes sold in the market now. Last year, Mallika variety of mangoes was sold for rupees 60, but this time it has gone up by 31 rupees and sold at 91 rupees per kilogram. Similarly, the price of Raspuri mangoes is up by rupees 16. The Malgoa variety is sold at rupees 90 compared to rupees 75 last year. The Alfonso mangoes have had a meager hike of rupees 4 from last year. The Sindura, which was sold for rupees 35 last year, is sold for rupees 40 this time around. The Badami variety of mango has seen a rise of rupees 28, but the price of Totapuri has remained the same and is being sold at rupees 25.
Because there are no rains. And definitely, because of no rains, naturally, the crop would die. And so definitely, the rates are on a higher side, and inflation also is a part of it. So I think so. It should come down after these rains. That is what they are predicting in May. But this time, there could be a draft, like, thing they are thinking of that sort. But I do not know, because meteorological, sometimes they may be wrong. They are not sure about it. So let us see. I think they are the best people. They are good people. They are very kind people. They would tell everyone, no, this is good and take it. Naturally, I'm a doctor. So in fact, to have fruits as an antioxidant, it is the best during summer. This is the best to eat.
But the price factor seems to have little impact on financially sound mango lovers as they continue to buy them despite considerable rise. Hence, Hopcoms has decided to import them from neighboring states of Andhra Pradesh and Tamil Nadu. Shobha Jojiga for News 9, Bengaluru.